Good evening and welcome to this 24th annual Halloween concert at St. Mark's. Glad you could join us this evening. And I'm happy to be joined this evening on the program with Erin McOmber, who will be singing, and Brent Hall will be at the keyboard. I'm going to start the program with three organ pieces. First, a piece by Louis Vierne, who was the organist of Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris, and I was lucky enough to be able to play a concert there last year and really got in the mood for this. He was the organist there from 1900 to 1937 and died at the keyboard playing a church service. The next piece is a little short piece from the Renaissance period. And the third one is from the Baroque period, and it's a rather curious piece. It starts quietly enough, but ends in a real blaze of glory. So, three pieces on the organ.
Thank you.
thank Simon Binns. He is the one who has set up the camera equipment, the screen, and he's a big help. Also, he put the lights back in the organ chambers. There are about 5,000 pipes back there. You can only see a few from the front, but with the red lights back in the chambers, you get a better idea of how big those organ chambers are and how many pipes there are.
I kept on a rack. saw Venus, he was ravished, enthusiastic to a degree. He said 'twas just enormous, my appendix vermiformis, but he never said he loved me.
Is there a doctor in the house?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, good sir, please come forward. Would you let the ladies and gentlemen know what an appendix vermiformis is?
Yes, so the appendix vermiformis is the smallest organ in the body. It ends the small intestine, and it has the very important function of doing absolutely nothing.
Are you single?
With my esophagus, he was ravished, enthusiastic to a degree. He said 'twas just enormous, my appendix vermiformis, but he never said, no, he never.
This next piece is a serious piece of organ literature by the great German romantic composer Max Reger. It starts with a really thrilling introduction, and then there is a short statement, an eight-measure statement of the Passacaglia theme in the pedals. And he keeps spinning out these different variations on top of this, much in the form that Bach did his famous Passacaglia in C minor.
Thank you.
They say I've brought pleasure to millions or more, and darling Craig Jessop gives me the top score when I sing. He can't help but to cheer. I'm a dame with a name at the peak of my fame. I'm known as the Empress of Song. The Donald Bravos and Miss Hillary Glows, but I cannot help feeling they're wrong. Well, actually they're wrong about a lot of things. I'm lauded, applauded, recorded, and kissed. I'm a musical flaw that they seem to have missed.
Oh,
much good luck as a performer. I've been cast in almost every show, from Carousel to Hair. On Broadway I was there, but you'd never, never know. Perhaps you picked me out last year in Phantom, or underneath my dirt in Miserable. But if you tried to pick me out from all the voices in the crowd, I'm certain that you must have had a problem. My plight is quite familiar to those who tread the boards at the Niederlander, Schubert, and Rialto. Although I've got a great high salary, the reaction seems to be...
That's great, dear. But we need you singing alto.
Please give me a chance to sing melody. Give me a crack at the tune. I'm filled with chagrin every time I begin by the light of the silvery moon. Just one little crack at the melody. Give me a moment to shine. I'm sick.
From school are we, hurt as a schoolgirl well can be, filled to the brim with girlish glee. Three little mates from school.
Touch me, it's so easy to leave me. What mirror where? Which hook where?
We started the program with a piece from Paris, from a Gothic cathedral, and we'll end now, a piece by Henri Mullet, Thou Art the Rock, wonderful piece in F sharp minor.